Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to Hope at Home, live from my living room in the middle of Berlin. Christoph Israel on the piano and me, Daniel Hope. We have reached the 10th episode in a row of this series, and we decided to say a big thank you not only to Arte Concert for allowing us to create this series, but to everybody out there who has been so closely in touch with us these last 10 days. We had the brief to complete 14 episodes, and 10 of 14 are there. And with double figures, we thought it was time to pay a special tribute to everybody who's been writing in. And so today's program, we're going to feature all the pieces that Christoph and I play are requests, people that have written in from around the world asking for specific pieces of music. And we began tonight with America the Beautiful, a magnificent and wonderful piece, which of course means so much to many people, but especially to so many Americans. And anybody seeing the pictures out of America must be very concerned and worried, as we are. And to all my friends in America, I wanted to send this message to you. In this case, it was Frederick and Monica in Seattle who requested this, and also Barbara in Savannah, Georgia. Both wanted very much to hear this music at this time, and it's our pleasure to play it for you. Please stay at home and please stay safe. We have especially received last night an extraordinary number of messages about Robert Wilson and his very, very moving tribute to our times. If you missed it, you can see it again in the Arte Concert website or in the media library. And Mr. Wilson was our guest yesterday. He specifically wrote texts about staying at home, about the situation, which he read. And Christoph Israel and I performed music by Arvo Pärt. And this seems to have reached so many people around the world. There were a few questions. Was it really live? Yes, it was really live. We do this every evening from 6 p.m. Berlin time. It comes live and direct to you. And people asked, did we rehearse it? Well, we rehearsed it for about 10 minutes before we played it. Of course, putting on a daily show with this music means that we have very little time to prepare, but when you have somebody like Robert Wilson here in the building, he is a huge inspiration, and he inspired us to come up with something specifically for you. The arrangement that you heard of America the Beautiful was composed this morning by Paul Bateman, a close friend of mine in England. Christoph and I are slowly running out of music, and Christoph himself is a magnificent arranger, but of course he also has to practice the pieces that we play in the evening. So thank you very much indeed, Paul, for coming to our rescue. We would like to play a couple of videos, and again, the request has come to play Piazzolla, and yes, we will try and play you some Piazzolla, but somebody has sent us a video with Piazzolla, and in fact, there are two close friends of mine. They live in Zurich. It's Nicola Mosca and his wife, and they have put together a beautiful selection, and we're going to play just a few seconds of a piece by Piazzolla. Was Natalia and Nicola Mosca, two magnificent musicians. You'd be interested to know that the young man there on the harp is actually a great cellist too. He's the principal cellist of our Zurich Chamber Orchestra, a man of many talents. And I thank you so much indeed for sending us that beautiful piece. That was Piazzolla's Tanti Anni Primi from his film music, Henry V. And Henry is a good word for the next person that has sent in a video to us. I've been thrilled to receive not only classical musicians works and ideas, but also from fledgling and singer-songwriters. And today we're going to feature a very famous singer-songwriter. But before we do that, I wanted to play you a clip that I've had from Henry Jukes in Wiltshire in England, who has written specifically this song. It's called, well, I'll let him explain.
Hi Daniel, thanks so much for having me on the show. My name's Henry Jukes and today I'm going to be playing a song for you. It's my own, it's called Lost For You. It's available on all streaming platforms. I hope you enjoy.
Why do I do the things I do? Why do I act so strange around you? I never thought I could win this war, when the only thing I can do is fall for you. And now you're gone, I feel so lost for you. And now you're gone, I feel so lost for you.
That was Henry Jukes in Wiltshire in England, and Lost For You, a song that he's written and very kindly recorded specifically for this program. Thank you very much indeed, Henry. Keep going and keep writing music, keep sharing it. You can find out more about him if you Google him, I'm sure. We'd now like to play another song which has been requested by many, many, many people. It's Moon River, and it was composed by Johnny Mercer and by Henry Mancini. And Johnny Mercer, in fact, has a connection to Savannah, Georgia. The Moon River is based in Savannah, Georgia. That's a town that I am very close to. For 16 years, I helped to organize the classical part of their music festival, and we have very, very close friends in Savannah. They're watching right now, and this is dedicated to you all. So, Moon River. That was the famous Moon River, which won the Academy Award in 1962 for the best song, of course made legendary by Audrey Hepburn, but by many, many other great musicians since then. That was an arrangement which was created this morning for the first part by Paul Bateman in England and completed this evening by Christoph Israel, who, as you could see, took another chorus. I could listen to him all day, and that's the great thing about Christoph. You can just give him a signal, and he keeps going, which is wonderful.
Took me by surprise, though. Thanks a lot.
As we say, we are live, and we do our best to keep this as live as possible. This is Hope at Home. It's the 10th episode in a row so far. I don't know about you, Christoph, but 10 times in a row, 10 concerts in a row, have you ever done that before?
Actually, I didn't think that we would survive until number 10.
Well, don't say it. We may not.
Now we're here at number 10. We have two figures, as you said. And when I look back, I'm really happy, not just about what guests we had, but most of all, what responses we had from the people. And it's so fulfilling to achieve such, or to reach out to such an audience and to get all these messages back. That's really worth doing it.
It really is. And as I said, today we are playing requests. So people who have asked for this. And that last Moon River, I think we had at least 7 or 8 requests, but particularly it was Jeff and Ramona in San Francisco. So thank you for tuning in. Thank you for being with us. We'd now like to play another request, again, a legendary song. This is from the year 1939. It was made famous, first of all, by Judy Garland. And I won't introduce it because I'm pretty sure you'll know exactly which song it's going to be.
Thank you.
That was Somewhere Over the Rainbow, arranged by Christoph Israel and by me, Daniel Hope. Welcome to Hope at Home. It's the 10th episode in a row live from my living room in Berlin. And one of the great things about this series for me is having friends here and having different guests come on, if not every night, then every other night. Last night we had Robert Wilson, the actor and director. And tonight we have somebody very, very special. He is a singer-songwriter. I had the pleasure of meeting him the first time back in 2008. I was organizing a concert to commemorate the 70th anniversary of what they call in Germany the Reichspogromnacht, or the Night of Broken Glass. And it was a charity concert to raise money for a charity educating young people about the dangers of racism and religious intolerance. And many of the artists that came to perform, in fact, have joined us these last few days. Christoph is one of them, Max Raber. And there was, at the time, a young pop singer. And when I reached out to different artists from different genres, he was the first person to accept. And at the time, he just created a song which is called Allein, Allein. It was in a band called Polarkreis 18. And this song went to number one in Germany and has been in the top 10 around the world for many, many years and keeps coming back. And I thought it would be nice to open the genres and to have a pop artist and have a singer-songwriter come and join us. And I'm thrilled that he's agreed to be here today. And so in true tradition, as you all know by now, I'm going to leave the room and prepare things for him. First thing I'm going to do is move this out of the way. And then I'm going to just pick up this stand. Just get everything ready for him. And without further ado, please welcome Felix Räuber.
Inside of him there's no one else, just a heart away. The time will come to be blessed, a heart away, to celebrate his loneliness. A line, a line, a line, a line, a line. Looking at faces, wait for a sign.
Vielen Dank, Felix. Unsere Premiere hier heute Abend. Sehr schön, dass du hier bist. Wie ist es für dich in diesen Zeiten? Alle Musiker, die hier waren, natürlich berichten von Konzerten, die weggebrochen sind. Bei dir natürlich ganz bestimmt das Gleiche. Wie geht es dir persönlich dabei?
Should I speak in English or should I speak in German?
You could also speak in English. I just asked Felix, very nice to invite me, how he's feeling about the situation.
So this is the right microphone.
Exactly.
Okay, I try to speak in English, but I have a little bit of Saxony kind of accent, but
very
I think
charming.
It's okay. Yeah, for me, first of all, it's very great to be here with you and to share company in real and not only virtual. I mean, we saw it like with Daniel's, all these nice messages. The virtual time is more important right now, and it's important for us to connect us, to overcome loneliness, which I described in my song. And for me, it's a bit of a reset knob, which I moved because I don't have to travel too much anymore. And to be honest, I like this kind of silent in between. And I also, I think it's very important, especially for someone who's creating things like us, it's very important to think about what can we do when it's going on after. Maybe we can change something, maybe we can change some small things, and I think about that all the time. Some small things, for example, we have time, we can talk to each other, we can spend our time together. And yeah, it's just an interesting kind of research moment, which I really appreciate.
And Felix, your hit song, Alone, I mean, even back in 2008, mm-hmm. it had such a success, it hit a nerve, and now it seems to have hit a nerve again. I mean, there's, of course, many people out there who are alone at the moment, who are not connected mm-hmm. to their loved ones, and how important is it for you to be making music still now and yeah. sending a message to them?
I think the feeling of loneliness, especially in times like that, a lot of people are connected to this kind of feeling, and I wanted to give this feeling a voice because we are all, we related to this feeling. And I thought in times right now, it's very important to think about how we are communicating, because we think that we, through digital communication, for example, that we are connected to each other. But I think we definitely have to make a decision, what's the way of communication we would like to have in the future, not to be alone. Because a lot of people are talking to each other without seeing each other anymore. And I think the feeling gets stronger through that. And I think that's maybe the reason why the song is getting another impact right now.
And you very kindly asked me to come and join the two of you for this last song. Tell us about it. What are we going to hear?
And the next song is a very personal song for me because it describes my vacations through Near East after my band. It was broken up. For me, it was a very tough time because I did not know if I have to do a normal job or if I can stay as a musician and earning my money with that. And so vacations helped me to get new influences. And the first song which came out was, after my vacation to the Near East, was the track Wall. And the Wall describes my inner wall, which I had in mind before I traveled there. And then I made some very different experiences and I realized, okay, the inner wall, or I'm closer than I thought inside. And so, yeah, that's, I think it's a good song. And very thank you that we are able to play together. See your hopes collapsing in slow-mo. It starts with a gleam, then trembles and dies.
did all wrong. Down to some piled up high to be. A wall. Their new freedom have gone long ago. With every punch of a fist, only hate seems to grow more to the sky. Till there's nothing left but a world in a wall and a knackers that bleed. How could we turn out like this when we just wanted? We've only been just wanted to be. Between cold shards of glass, be safe in our mother's arms, dreaming of mercy and tenderness inside, and that the wall between us would start. Would start a fire. Would start a fire. Dreaming of mercy and tenderness inside.
That was the song Wall, sung, written by Felix Huber, my guest, our guest tonight at Hope at Home. Thank you so much indeed, Felix, for joining us. Before that, Align, Align, Alone, Along, Alone, Alone, his hit song written in 2007, but is still being played all the time, especially now. We hope very much that you enjoyed the show and that you'll join us. If you missed this show or any other of the shows, you can go to the Arte Concert Media Library, where all the shows are available. And tomorrow night, we'll have another pop artist joining us. He comes from the legendary Rammstein band. It's Flacker, the keyboard player. So we are continuing to open up the genres here on Hope at Home. And until then, please stay at home, be safe, and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.